NASCAR announced some major changes for 2024. Apparently, Tuesday, January 23rd is NASCAR's day to just drop all of their news before the lead up to the season, because they announced a number of changes for both the Cup Series and the Xfinity Series in 2024. So let's get into it real quick. One of the most odd announcements that they made to me was the fact that pit road walls will now be allowed to have video board signage on them. So the wall where the pit crew jumps over at, that can now, instead of just having a banner that says, you know, McDonald's or 3Chi or Pennzoil on it, that can now be a video board supplied by the team that will have rotating ads on it. So if you have a team that has multiple sponsors, like Raptor, Liberty, Exalta, and whatever else William Byron has, you can rotate that through on the video board. So teams can now, in theory, sell sponsorship for their video board. So if you're going to a night race at any point this year, you can just expect pit road to look like Times Square, just absolutely lit up. Trackhouse has to be absolutely ecstatic about this. Justin Marks audibly moaned. He had a bit of a crisis when he heard this. He was like, oh, this is amazing, because they love video boards at Trackhouse, which is cool. Their haulers look great with the video boards on them. But for NASCAR to announce that they're going to allow this is a bit of a change, because it wasn't something they previously allowed. It will be interesting to see if they use them at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, though, because Indianapolis famously does go around and put in all of these stickers on the pit boxes for the teams. They do it for the Indianapolis 500, and they do it for the Brickyard 400 as well. And I think it's one of those cool old school touches. So if they get rid of that and put a video board on, I don't think it would be as cool. I also think that you have to look at some of the racetracks where you're going to be having these video boards at, and some where you're not going to be, because at some tracks it's just not going to make sense. Like Sonoma, there's really no point in putting a video board on your wall at Sonoma, because you're not really getting access to the fans, and you're not going to get that much more signage, you know, viewership from the TV audience as you would if you just had a vinyl banner there. So I think there are some things to work out through this, but it does remind me a lot of like the Ricky Bobby Fig Newton thing, where he's like, this sticker is really inconvenient, but boy, do I love some Fig Newtons. At this point, we're just selling sponsorship everywhere. Obviously, the vinyl banners already had sponsorship on them, but the ability to now have a video board there to rotate sponsors through is certainly interesting. And I think it could probably be pretty confusing as you're getting ready to pull into your pit box. I imagine every team will essentially have tested this out during pit stop practice with one of these boards, and then they'll have just a general, you know, brand that will be on that every single time the driver comes into the pit box. That way they're able to locate it where they're going. But that is a massive change for NASCAR, and it's a step in a different direction. I don't hate it. I'm interested to see what it looks like. I haven't seen a mock-up of one yet, but it could potentially be cool. It'll look really cool during night races. Like I said, they'll be very bright, especially if they're those LED like ribbon boards that you have at stadiums. It's going to be pretty bright. Also, who's moving all of these from track to track? Are the teams responsible for it, or is the company that moves the pit boxes for them responsible for it? Just feels like another thing that we're going to have to start moving around the country for the teams. Outside of that, an actual like competition thing that has changed, NASCAR has changed up how qualifying will be done in the Cup Series in 2024, or in all series in 2024. So there's no real format change. There's still Group A, Group B, and then, you know, the top 10 shootout, which I don't love a top 10 shootout. Who really cares at this point? But for all the cars that don't make it into the top 10 shootout, every car that qualifies in Group A, they will now start in all of the even numbered positions. So they'll start in the outside line. All the cars that qualify in Group B, they'll start in all of the odd numbered positions, the inside line on the racetrack. And I know there's going to be a lot of people that probably complain about this, right? Because previously NASCAR set the order by speed. So if you had the first fastest speed, or technically the sixth fastest speed in Group A, then you could, then you obviously would start in pole. But if you were the second fastest in Group A, you know, A, but also that ranked you higher than what the first fastest speed in Group B was, well, then you would just start in 12th then, and then it would work its way on down. So now it doesn't matter. If you're second, you know, if you're seventh fastest in Group A, you'll start, you know, right there in the outside line behind the car that was sixth fastest in Group A, and then so on and so forth for the odd numbers as well. I know some people complain about that, but there were a number of instances over the last couple of years where, you know, Group A or Group B, one of the two had a pretty favorable track condition compared to the other one. So you would see some speeds in the latter group that were way different than the speeds that you saw in the first group. Or you would see guys that were fastest in, you know, Group A, they wouldn't even have made it into the top seven in Group B. And that's a problem. And so moving it to this, I don't hate it. I understand why people are, you know, potentially going to complain about it. But from a fairness standpoint and a track evolution standpoint, it makes a lot more sense to have it set up this way, how they're doing it now versus how they previously had done it before. So I don't really have that big of an issue with this one. NASCAR also announced some changes to the Xfinity and Truck Series in 2024 as well. For the Truck Series and the Xfinity Series, there will be all live pit stops in 2024. So in 2023, they had run non-competitive pit stops on races where they weren't companion races with the Cup Series and on road courses. They were all, you know, non-competitive pit stops. So everybody came in, change your tires in a certain allotted time, you're all pit road, and you just go right back to your position. Now, all pit stops are live. Once again, absolutely love that decision. This is a team sport, is a competition sport, and having non-competitive pit stops, while I understand from a budget situation, does save teams money, it does take away a bit of that competition and that team sport aspect. So I like the change that they have going on here. In the Xfinity Series, they've also gotten rid of the 11-gallon fuel can, and they've now reduced it to a 9-gallon fuel can. The thought process behind that is you won't have to have such a big-bodied, strong person to carry around the 11-gallon. You can get someone of a smaller stature to carry around the 9-gallon. It reduces it by like 10 to 15 pounds, they say at least. So the idea behind that is you won't have to go out and hire a big athlete to, you know, lug this thing around. You can hire somebody, again, of a smaller stature. I don't really have that big of a complaint about this. I'm sure some people will. Whatever, you can complain all of you want. We also have a backup car change for the Xfinity Series. So now, teams with 1 to 2 cars are allowed to bring one backup car to the racetrack. Teams with 3+ cars can bring 2 backup cars to the racetrack. Only one of those cars can be prepped, though. The other one can just be a car, and then you have to move all of the internals over to it. None of the backup cars can be wrapped. They all have to be one color. And for the championship 4, all 4 drivers get to bring their own backup car to the race, which I think that's just completely understandable. This is a move to help teams save some money. And with limited practice time now and just qualifying, we don't see a ton of incidents. There will be some teams that definitely run into issues this year because some of those drivers certainly do wad up cars at an exponential rate compared to others. But again, this isn't something that's, you know, that huge of a change. Not wrapping the cars is going to look a little bit odd once we see a car roll out the back of one time and they just have to slap some decals on it without like the actual wrap. But yeah, overall, don't really have a problem with that one. And then NASCAR also announced that they are in the process of building a command center at their new NASCAR media headquarters in Charlotte, which is not a bad thing. So think of what the NFL has, right? They have a command center in New York. The refs call New York. The replays are done there, this and that. They can make calls from New York. That's essentially what NASCAR is building, a command center where they will be able to watch races, and they hope by the end of the year to be able to make calls during races remotely from Charlotte. People are still going to be in the tower. People are still going to be at the racetrack. All the officials are still going to be there, but it'll be another set of eyes in Charlotte keeping track of all of those Hawkeye cameras and stuff that's watching pit road. And they'll have different angles and stuff that maybe they don't have in the booth currently. Kind of like the William Byron running into the back of Denny Hamlin thing at Texas and spinning him out where they were like, oh, we didn't see this in real time. Maybe a command center could see something like that in real time and be able to make a call quicker than what NASCAR, you know, dealt with when that actually happened. I can see both sides of this argument. There's going to be some people that absolutely hate it, some people that absolutely love it. I like the idea of NASCAR being able to make calls in real time as they're happening. I like the idea of that where we don't go into a post race and then have them come out on Monday or Tuesday and be like, oh, they're getting penalized for this and that. Just make the call as it's happening. At the same time, I can see people being like, just let it happen. Human error is a thing. Like, if you have to figure it out on Monday or Tuesday, then so be it, but don't affect the outcome of a race as it's happening. I don't love that idea either. I can see the argument for it. Again, don't love it. NASCAR is going to do this, though, as they continue to build out that new media center that they have there. And I like the idea of having more eyes on the sport. I don't necessarily love the idea of being governed more or stricter, maybe is the right term for it. But I think I'm open to the idea of what they're about to do and kind of want to see how it plays out. So we'll see how all of it goes. But for the most part, NASCAR announced a lot of things, and I think there's a few things in that you know, rundown that I just gave right there that are certainly interesting. Nothing that's like too glaring where you're like, I absolutely hate this. All of it makes sense for the most part when you think about it. NASCAR did also announce that Xfinity Series director Wayne Otten, after 40 years, would be stepping down from his role at the end of the season, but will remain with NASCAR. So that's a bit of a bummer because I think Wayne runs a pretty good ship over there in the Xfinity Series. And we've seen with NASCAR moving on from guys like David Hoots and whatnot that, you know, race directing is hard and getting somebody else good in there is difficult. And they've certainly had some growing pains recently over the last couple of years after getting moving on from David. Hopefully they don't have those same, you know, growing pains moving on from Wayne and he gets these people trained up correctly. But let me know in the comments if you like these changes. Like and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on TikTok @BreakHard, Instagram and Twitter @BreakHardPlay.